So good evening, everyone.
大家晚上好。
Yesterday I talked about I did three-month retreats in Korea when I was a layperson.
昨天呢，我谈到，当我还是一个在家中的时候，在韩国的一些经验。
And Zen Master De Bong was leading the retreat at that time.
大峰禅师当时是领导的，领导法师。
So that was my very first three-month winter retreat.
那是我第一回做这个冬季的节前安居。
And I spent a lot of that retreat watching movies.
那在那安居的时候呢，大部分的时间我都在看电影。
So I had this like two or three movies that I would watch every day.
那每天呢，我就看这两三套电影
，in my head，
就在脑子里面看。
So every day, a lot of the time was the same movie.
每天播放的都是同一部电影。
And usually, you know, I never would watch a movie two or even my favorite movie, I would never watch more than three or four times.
一般上呢，就算是我最喜欢的电影啊，我也不会看超过两三回。
But this movie is 90 days, 90 times, same movie.
但这一出东安居的电影呢，我就看了九十天呐。
And I don't understand. I didn't find it boring.
可我不明白的就是，我并没有觉得它无聊啊。
And then also, when you watch, you know, this is not sometimes not such a nice movie. This emotion, angry, or desire, or fear appear.Every single time.
所以不是一部很好的电影，因为每当看的时候，内在的里面的那个心情绪都不断的起伏啊，嗔恨啊，执着啊，情欲等等。
Very interesting, yeah.
那是蛮有趣的，是吧
？So I think a lot of you already spent one day on retreat.
你们大家都花了一天的时间在这里。
Maybe you watch some of your own movies also.
你们也看了你们自己的电影了，是吧？
And, you know, on retreat, after a while, you get to realize, I'm watching this movie again and again.
但是呢，在禅修精进的时候呢，你会发现到，哎，我一直在重复的看这部电影，同样的一部电影。
And you have a chance to do something about it.
那你可以做一些介入，或者什么行动呢？
But in everyday life, usually you're so busy with your thinking that all these movies, it's like real.
但是呢，在一般的日常生活里，你所看到的那部电影都是好，感觉好像很真实。
All the stuff you worry about, all the stuff you want, all the stuff that you wish for, everything, it just keeps on going nonstop from one movie to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next.
你所看到的，你所想要的，你所希望的，你所期待的，都不断的、不断的在重复。
And you're so busy with your lives, you don't realize it's just some movie.
那你日常生活中那么的忙碌，你没有真正的发现到这是一部在重复的电影。
Maybe you're so busy on Tinder. Should I swipe left or right? Left, right. Which one? Left, 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 right, right. No, you're so busy doing that maybe that you don't notice.
可能你每天忙着看手机的应用程序那个 apps 啊，刷左呢还是刷右？刷左还是刷右？忙到你没机会看你自己心里的那部电影。
Looks like you guys don't use Tinder. Very good.
你们都不用这 Tinder 这个 app 吧？
Anyway, so I'd like to share a story with you about that.
那我想跟大家分享一个关于这个方面的故事。
Not about Tinder.
不是 Tinder app 的事情。
Many years ago, when I first went to Hong Kong, I found a job around the same time as I met Zen Master Song San.
好多年前呢，当我去香港的时候，我刚好在遇到松山禅师那时候呢，我也刚刚好开始了新的工作，
so、
就在香港。
This was a job that I really wanted, so I wanted to really impress my boss because I was a new guy.
因为我很想得到那份工作，所以当我上任的时候呢，我就很想的去给我一个我的上司一个好的印象。
So after about a month of being in the job, he asked me to make a presentation for him.
那上班大概上了一个月之后呢，我的老板叫我做一个做一个呈现一个presentation.
Because he was going to meet with all the big company heads and in a big meeting, very important meeting, all the big guys, and he needed to present information about our work.
因为他老板呢需要给在一个很大的会议上见好多很重要的人物很重要的头目呢，他需要给他们做一个报告一个演说。
So I worked very hard, made a good presentation, gave it to him. I thought, yeah, he's really going to be impressed.
那我给他做了一份，我努力的工作，给他做了一份很好很好的报告。那我希望他会有用。
Then next day he had this meeting, and the meeting was like 2-3 day meeting.
第二天呢，就老板就开始他的那个开会，因为呢开会呢是两三天的一个会议。
So for lunch break he came back to the department. Then I saw him. I was thinking he's gonna say good, good.
那午餐的时候呢，他回来回到公司，他看当时我看到老板的时候，我就猜想啊，他一定会跟我说，好，干得好。
So he came up to my desk and said, you know, was there some mistake in the presentation?
那他来到我的桌，办公桌，然后他说，你知道吗？在那个报告里面是不是有什么差错啊？
When he said mistake, it's like somebody had punched me in the face. I was so shocked. I made a mistake, you know. I was also very scared.
那当我听到他说报告有误，我就觉得好像被人打了一拳，那我也非常的恐惧。
So for a moment, I didn't know what to say. Then I said, I check. I don't think so. I check. Then he said, yeah, you check. Okay.
那当时呢，我就回复跟他说，我不大清楚。那我查一下好不好？老板说，好的，你去查吧。
Then he went to his office, and I, like, my face all white, and sat down, and I, you know, quickly got out all the computer, all the spreadsheets, everything, checking.
那老板回到他的办公室，我就回到我的座位上，然后呢，我的脸应该是非常苍白。那我不断的在找那些数据，挖出来。
And I couldn't find a mistake.
可是我找不到错误啊。That's
the worst thing, because your boss thinks you made a mistake, but you can't find it.
当你的老板说你的报告有误，但是你本身找不出那个错误的时候，那是个非常糟糕的事情。So
I think I made some mistake, but I couldn't find it. So then soon, very hard to swallow. Like, very tight here.
那老板说我有错的错误，但是我找不到的错误，所以我非常的不安，连吞口水啊都有问题。Then
head very heavy.
那头啊很重重的感觉。Then
you know, 5 o'clock came, six. He went home. I was still on the computer.
5点钟到了，老板回家，我呢还在那边不断的在电脑上的打呀打呀的找问题在哪里。
10 o'clock, I was still in the office. Where's my mistake? Couldn't find it.
晚上4点钟呢，我还在办公室，我的问题到底出现在哪里呢？
Then started to really worry, scared, you know, really scared.
那我就非常的担心，而且非常的害怕。
Because I was working for American company, so I knew, you know, because I was only 1 month, if I had major problem, then I get fired straight away.
因为那当时，That's what I thought. 因为当时我觉得我那间是美国公司，而我才工作一个月，如果真的有出差错的话，我可能会当场被开除的。Then
I thought if I get fired, I have no money.
我当时担心呢，如果被开除的话，没钱呢。If
I have no money, I can't pay the rent for the flat, the apartment.
没钱就没钱交租了。Then
no apartment, nowhere to stay. Then what can I do?
没钱交租，流落街头，怎么办？
I have to go home to Malaysia.
要回去马来西亚了。Ah,
then I have to face my friends and my parents.
啊，回去还要见乡亲父老的呀。Then
I'm so shameful, you know.
哎呀，太羞愧了，太无面了，无脸见人了。
No face.
太无脸了，没脸了，没面子。
Loser, L-O-S-E-R.
啊，失败者。
So this thinking around and around, and I even 10:30 I went home, I knew I had to go back home, still very tight, lie down, cannot sleep.
那念头呢一直在那边打转啊转啊转啊，十点半我觉得应该是回家了，可是当我回到家的时候觉得脖子好像被掐住这样一直睡不着。
My head was spinning. Loser, loser, loser.
那我的脑海里边在转着失败者失败者失败者。
So I don't know, eventually maybe I'm so tired I fell asleep maybe at 4 or 5 a.m.
我不晓得可能到时候一直在连转到大概四点钟才入眠。
Then, you know, 7 o'clock wake up and go to office.
那七点钟起来上班
thinking maybe I find mistake but still cannot find.
那我在想啊，可能我会找到那个问题在哪，可是一直找不到错误在哪里啊。
Then afternoon came, my boss again lunch break come back and I was thinking,Okay, now die time.
那午餐时间到了，又到了，老板回来走向我的桌子，
so、
我就想这次死定了。
He went to office, then my hands were like this.
那老板呢就回到他的办公室，我的手一直在这样。
Wait for him to call me in and say, you know, that's just the end for you. Bye bye.
那我就等着他把我叫进他的办公室，然后告诉我说：“你知道吗？”
So I was like, you know, waiting on, like they say, waiting on tenterhooks, you know.
那我就一直坐在那边忐忑，心里忐忑不安，七上八下的。
But whole afternoon passed, nothing happened.
那过了整个下午呢，什么事也没发生过。
Then I don't know, very confused, what's happening?
那我就在想，哎呀，真的不晓得，真纳闷，真的是。
By that time, not enough sleep. Worry like crazy. Very tired. I just went home at, I don't know, 6-7 o'clock. I lie down, completely fall asleep.
那时候呢，又缺睡，又累。那回到家呢，可能是6-7点吧，躺下就睡了。
But still very scared.
还是很害怕。
Yeah. Then, next day,Went to office again. Nothing happened.
那第二天呢？到了办公室也没事情发生。
And next day, nothing. Also, nothing happened.
那接着一天过一天，再过一天，都非常的平静。
Then eventually, after 1 week, I thought, maybe he won't fire me.
那过了一周之后呢？我在想说，他可能不会把我开除了。
But I spent 1 whole week suffering, worry.Scared, cannot eat.
可是呢，那一周呢，我就在恐惧、忧虑、吃不下的情况下过了一周。
And by the way, it's a very good way to lose weight, you know.
顺便说呢，那要减、要瘦身呢，那是非常好的办法。
So, I made all this up, the whole thing.
那一整团东西呢，都是我自己制造出来的。
For all the way from getting fired to not having any money to going back home to being a loser, it was all in my mind. But I really felt it.
那从被开除、没钱、流落街头、回到马来西亚，都是我自己在创造的、编写的一段故事。那虽然是编写的故事，但是我还是感受得到，身临其境的感受到。
But that time, I didn't know. I thought this is real. It's real.
可是那时候我觉得那是非常的真实的。
It's going to happen.
它将会发生的。
You have experienced that? Like you think it's really real, it's going to happen, but doesn't happen?
你们经历过这种吗？就是好像感觉好像将要发生，但其实不会发生的。
So, that's our daily life sometimes, you know?
那就是我们的日常生活的。
But the great thing about practicing and also coming on retreat is that you can stop.And see your thinking, see the stuff that you're making up.
可是来这里禅修的好处就是啊，你可以静下来，好好看看你所自己所编写的一些故事。
Then, if you see it, then when you realize as the way that we teach, you return to your breath, come back to just now.
当你看清楚了，去用我们的教你的方法，回到当下，回到你的呼吸，就回到当下呢？
That time, you already let that go, or you put it down.
那时你已经把它放下了。
That's really very, very simple to do.
那是非常的简单的。
But it's not so easy to practice.
但要实行并不容易。
That's why practice meditation is very important.
那就是为什么修行静坐禅修是非常重要的。
Because as you practice, just coming back, coming back, coming back, all this stuff that's going on in your head becomes less loud, becomes softer.
因为当你不断的练习怎么回到当下，回到当下的时候呢，那在你脑子里面转了转了，这些事情会，这些声音呢会越来越逐渐的小去远去。
And many times you can experience, ah, that's my thinking. You feel it, but you realize, ah, that's just this thinking that you can let go. And with more practice, you can control it.
那渐渐的你会知道，虽然你还是感受到，但你知道那是我的思维，那可以放下的。
All this anxiety, all this worry, all this stress, all this, you know, want something, all that you can control.
那这些忧虑呢，担心呢，恐惧呢，你的执着呢，这些你都可以控制，可以放下的，可以掌握的。
Because when you practice, your center gets stronger, and then your mind is stronger. Then all this stuff, not such a big problem anymore.
因为当你的中心强的时候呢，那这些东西，这些旁边的东西呢，都不重要了。
So that's all you have to do. You have a great meditation center here. Great sunims can help you. Great teachers, and all you have to do is just show up.
那其实很简单的。你有一个很好的禅中心，你有很好的导师们教你，那你所只要做的就是出现出席。
Better than getting stressed out, right?
总比受压力好吧，对吗
？So, thank you all for your practice.
谢谢大家的修行。
And thank you all for listening.
谢谢大家的聆听。
Thank you, Myung-an. Some interesting story.
谢谢明眼师父，你的故事很有趣。
Also, thank you everyone for your practice today.
谢谢大家今天的修行。
Our practice has two parts, two aspects.
我们的修行呢有两部分。
Meditation and wisdom.
禅修还有智慧。
Meditation means a not moving mind.
禅修呢就是不动的心。
When you're doing something, just do it.
那当你做事情呢，只是去做。
So that's possible any kind of body position, any kind of activity.
不论你身体姿势是怎么样，或者你在做任何的事情，心不动。
Not only sitting.
不单单只是坐的时候。
When you're driving, just drive.
驾车的时候只是驾车。
When you're cooking, just cook.
煮东西的时候只是煮。
When you're with your family, just family mind.
和家人在一起的时候只是和家人在一起。
When you're sitting, just sitting practice.
当你坐的时候呢，只是坐。
But it actually is not so easy.
其实不是那么的简单啊。
Because we all have many habits.
因为我们有好多的习性或习惯。
So even when we're doing something, often we're thinking something else.
就算当我们在做某些事情的时候，心呢是想着其他东西的。
So we call practicing.Practice, stay in this moment.
所以呢，我们说修行，修行，修行在当下。
So you already tried today.
啊，你们今天已经尝试过了。
Many hours sitting.
坐了好多小时。
So actually, so easy. Sit. I don't have to do anything.
其实很简单，只是这么做，什么也不用做，其他的不用做。
Sit up straight. Breathe in, breathe out.
只是坐得端正，吸。呼
thinking not necessary.
是连想都不用去想啊。
But everybody's mind very busy.
可是每个人的心呢都非常的忙碌。
It's like driving your car from the temple home, then you park it, then you get out of your car, go upstairs. You don't need the car now, maybe 12 hours, but you never turn it off.
就像如等一下，待会你从禅中心驾车回到家，你把车停在家楼下，然后回到楼上继续做你的事情，然后睡觉。可是你忘了把车关掉。
You don't need the car to go someplace, but you leave it running.
你已经不需要那辆车子了， 你也不要去，不用去驾车去哪里。可是呢，你还却没有把汽车的引擎关掉。
Who here would do that on purpose?
谁在这里，谁在当众会那么的做的呢
？Anybody does that, we'd say you're stupid.
如果有人那么做，我们会说他笨。
You make the car get older fast by running it.
那你让你的车快一点的退化。
You waste a lot of money by burning up the gas, not taking you anywhere.
你让汽油不断的燃烧，浪费金钱。
So nobody would do that.
没有人会这么做的。
But we do that with our mind.
可是呢，我们就这样的对待我们的心事。
Because we can't control it.
因为我们掌握不了我们的心事。
We made our mind, then we can't control it.
我们制造了心事，但是我们不能够掌握的心事。
It's like the movie Frankenstein.
就像是Frankenstein 这部电影。
Frankenstein makes a monster.He's so happy I made life. Then he can't control it.
Frankenstein 医生呢，他制造了一个科学怪人，但是呢，他不能够控制这怪人，不能掌握这怪人。
So practicing means training our mind.
那所谓的修行呢，就是锻炼我们的心事。
Maybe we realize one moment there's no mind at all.
可能我们在某一刹那发现到，其实没有心。
But understanding that and attaining it are completely different.
可是呢，要了解这个无心，还有证入这个无心呢，是完全两回事。
During interviews for the people who were beginning, we talked about our mind is like a mirror.
在小餐的时候呢，我们谈到我们的心就像一副明镜。
Not even our mind, just the true nature itself is like a mirror. When we don't make opposites thinking.It just reflects this moment.
不只是我们的心，一切的事物都是如此。我们的心就都如一面明镜。当我们不去执着的时候，它只是在反照。
Walls white.
墙是白色的。
Floors brown.
地板是黄的。
Dog goes ruff ruff.
狗是呼呼。
Everything's already the truth.
一切已经是真理了。
Think about it, not necessary.
去想也想都不用想。
Drive your car, light turns red, step on the brake.
驾车的时候，交通灯转红的时候，只踩踏刹车器。
It's automatic.
很自然的。
But we all have desire, anger, ignorance.
但是我们都有贪嗔痴。
So we practice bringing our attention back into the present moment, whatever we're doing.
所以呢，我们锻炼在无论我们做什么事情的时候呢，都把心。摄受到当下。
Actually, it's hard work, isn't it?
其实是非常辛苦的一件工作，是不是？
But once we burn off all these unnecessary things, it's very easy.
但是呢，当我们把这些不需要的杂物一切都燃烧掉的时候呢，就非常的简单了。
The name for that is meditation.
其名就是禅修。
When you're doing something, just do it.
当你做某件事的时候，只是去做。
So that's what we're practicing together.
那就是我们大家一起在修行的。
Second part is a wisdom.
第二部分呢是智慧。
Everybody has many ideas. We don't even know some of the ideas we have.
每个人呢都有许多的不同的理念想法。我们有一些理念想法我们都不知道的存在。
Myung An Sinim was worried he made a mistake.
明眼师父担心他犯错。
One thought.Grew into 1 week of suffering.
一个念头呢，转变为一周的痛苦。
I thought he was going to say that the next day the boss came to him and said, "You know, there wasn't any mistake."
我刚才呢还以为他会说他的老板告诉他，哦，一个礼拜后，他老板又告诉他说，其实没有什么问题。
I was just checking if you trust your work.
我只在考验你对你自己有没有信心呢。
So we also say, you must believe in your true self.
所以我们呢说呢，你要相信自己的自信。
But a good teacher can see that's your clear mind functioning or some idea functioning.
但是好的老师呢，能够看得出你到底是自信在运作呢，还是你的理念和想法在运作。
Wisdom is not like something you learn in school.
智慧呢，不是你在学校所学的。
That's knowledge, understanding.
那是知识，是了解。
That's a somebody else's idea you can carry around in your head.
那是把别人的理念放在自己的脑子里面。
Wisdom means this moment, you and the universe become one, then the correct action appears.
智慧呢，就是当下宇宙和你，你和宇宙合一，那你所反映出来的就是正确的行动。
The only way to really attain that is take away my opposite thinking.
唯一所能达到这个方法呢，就是把我的二元的思维放下。
Then everything becomes your wisdom.
那一切呢，都转为智慧。
If you digest your experience, it changes, becomes wisdom.
当你好好的消化你的经验的时候呢，它就转变为你的智慧。
If you digest your understanding, if you digest your opinion, it becomes truth.
当你把你的观点观念消化呢，它就变成了真理。
Maybe you go outside and you look up, it's cloudy.
可能你走出去，你看往天看，觉得非常的乌云密布。
If you're maybe a rich person in America, maybe soon you're not happy. I want to go sunbathe, become tan.
如果你是在美国一个富人呢，你会觉得富有人家呢，你会觉得我不开心，因为我想晒晒热光浴。
In Korea, it's very interesting. Women in the city, if it's very sunny, they carry a sun umbrella.
那在韩国呢，非常有趣。妇女们呢，当如果是艳阳高照的时候呢，他们会带一个阳伞。
They don't want the skin to become brown.
他们不要把皮肤晒黑。
If your skin becomes brown, it means you're a farmer.
因为当你皮肤晒黑的时候，表示你是农民。
They want to be more white.
他们要皮肤白白的。
In America, if you're rich, you want to lay out in the sun with no clothes on and make your skin brown. It means you're rich. You can do nothing all day.
那如果你是在美国的有钱人家呢，你就想摊开衣服也不穿的，就让太阳把你的衣服晒到古铜色的，因为它代表你非常的富有，什么也不是用做，只要晒日光浴就好了。
So maybe young person in America sees it's cloudy. Soon they're thinking, that's too bad today.
那可能呢，在
I can't become brown today. And
可能呢，在美国的年轻人一看到乌云密布，就觉得不好啊，今天不能够晒一晒太阳啊。
Maybe Asian woman goes out. It's cloudy. Great, I don't have to carry an umbrella.
那可能亚洲的女性看到今天阴天，太好了，不用打伞。
But what's the truth?
那真理是什么呢？
It's cloudy. That's all.
阴天，就这样。
That's a wisdom.
那就是智慧。
Very simple.
就这么简单。
So, how get wisdom?
那怎么样得到这智慧呢？
What is the source of humans' ignorance?
人类的无明无知源头是在哪里呢？
In Buddha's teaching, the source of all humans' ignorance and suffering is a false idea of I.
在佛所教呢，一切无知无明的源头呢，就是一个我的观念。
Then we think our karma is I.
那我们就觉得我们的业力就是我。
That's just our karma.
那就只是我们的业力罢了。
Most of you have a Chinese karma, so you got a Chinese body.
你们大部分呢都有八个华人的业，所以呢你就有华人的身体。
Desmond and I have white man's karma, so we got white man body.
Desmond 和我呢都有白人的业力，所以我们是白人。
Men had men karma, so got a man's body.
男性有男性的业力，所以有男性的身体。
Woman made woman karma before life, so get a woman's body.
女性呢，前世有女性的业力，所以她们有女性的身体。
Somebody made happiness karma, then they are happy. Somebody made suffering karma, then many suffering.
有些人呢，制造了开心的业，所以有业开心， 那有些人制造的是痛苦的业，所以他们要痛苦。
That's not me, my karma.
那不是我，那不是我，那是我的业棍。
So if we attach to this idea I, then we're controlled by our karma.
那如果我们执着这个我呢，我们就被我们的业力所控制。
If we raise a big question inside, what am I? What is this thing I call I?
如果在里面我们提出一个内在，提出一个问题呢，到底我是什么呢？
And you pay attention.
当你专注的时候呢？
Try meditation when you're doing something, just do it.
修禅，然后当你做事的时候，只是去做。
Then you can see my true nature is not my idea.
那你就非常的看得非常清楚。我的自信和我的理念是两回事。
My true nature can do anything.
我的自信可以做任何事情。
Then slowly, slowly we can see our karma.
然后慢慢的、慢慢的，我们能看清楚我们的业。
Then we can control our karma.
那我们就可以掌握我们的业。
Then we can make our karma disappear.
那我们可以让我们的业消失。
Then we can use our karma without being attached to it.
那我们就可以。不执着我们的业而运用它。
Name for that is wisdom.
其名，它的名字就叫做智慧。
So, how do we get wisdom? Three ways.
所以呢，怎么得到这个业得到这个智慧呢？就有三个方式。
Have a big question inside.
就是在你里面有一个大疑团、大疑问。
Do together action with others.
和大家一起行动。
And correct Kong'an practice.
正确的公案修行。
Yeah. Kong'ans help our two things, they help our practice direction remain correct.
那公案做两帮我们两回事，第一是帮我们确保我们有正确的修行方向。
The direction of our practice is understand my true nature and help all beings.
正确的方向就是明白自性，帮助一切众生。
Our true nature is don't know.
我们的自性就是不知。
So when the teacher asks you a question and you don't know the answer,You're already going the correct way.
所以呢，当老师问你一个问题，你不知呢，你已经是朝正确的方向去了。
In university, if you don't know, you fail.
在大学里面，如果你说你不知呢，你就不过关了。
But in Buddhism, if you go straight, don't know, you get enlightenment.
在佛教呢，如果你只是不知，你就开悟了。
So Kong'an practicing first.Helps us keep our direction correct.
那公案修行先在前，然后呢，保持我们的方向正确。
Second, it helps us slowly, slowly our wisdom grow.
第二呢，它帮忙我们慢慢的增长我们的知识智慧。
Then you can begin to believe in your true nature.
那你就开始相信你的自信。
Each person, all of you, have all the wisdom you need.Inside of you for your life.
你们在座的每一个人呢，在你们内心已经有你所需要的一切的智慧了。
If it doesn't appear, that's only because it's covered by our attachment.
如果你的智慧没有显现，是因为你被你的执着所掩盖着。
If we practice, we can burn off this attachment and karma. Then, by itself, our correct wisdom will appear.
当我们不断的修行的时候呢，我们就可以把这个业还有这个消掉，然后正确的就会显现了。
If you can't solve the situation, only go straight, don't know. Then one day you can solve it.
那如果你不能解决问题呢，你只是朝着不知，那有一天你就能把问题解决了。
So our practice is two parts.
那我们的修行有两个部分。
Meditation, wisdom.
禅修，智慧。
Sanskrit word is samadhi and prajna.
梵文的呢就是 samadhi 还有 prajna.
Anybody have any questions about anything?
有没有谁有问题的？任何问题都可以。
Any kind of question.
任何一个问题。
Oh, over there.
Yes, it's all in the boxes.
Why don't you read it?
Okay.
Pick one and read it.
The first I pick is why we have.Kong'an practice, how it helps in the daily life. I think you just answered that.
Say it in Chinese.
第一个问题呢是为什么要有公案的 这个修行法呢，它怎么能在日常生活里面帮助我们呢？这个问题我相信刚才常师已经讲过了。
So I already answered. Wisdom means being able to function in our everyday life. So Kong'an practice helps our wisdom grow.
智慧呢，就是能够在我们的日常生活里面运作。那Kong'an呢，就帮助我们的，让我们的智慧增长。
All the Kong'ans are about various kinds of problems humans have in their life and with their mind.
Kong'an 呢，都是关于一切人类在日常生活里面，还有他们心智所遇到的问题。
Some Kong'ans are about how not to attach to opposites.
有些Kong'an呢，是关于不要执着相对的。
Some are about how to fix a mistake.
有些呢，是怎么有些Kong'an呢，是关于怎么修正。
Some are about seeing cause and effect clearly.
有些Kong'an呢，是关于看把因果看得非常清，看得清楚。
Some are about what is love, what is true love.
有些Kong'an呢，是关于什么是爱，什么是正爱。
So that helps us with our daily life.
那就能够帮在日常生活里面给我们帮助了。
And just like in Kong'an practice, if you don't know, in daily life, if you have a problem, rather than hold your opinion, just make a big question and don't know.
那就像在你修Kong'an的时候呢，你在日常生活里面，当你遇到问题的时候呢，你把你的那个知见放下，只是不知。
Why do I always fight with my mother?
为什么我老是跟我的妈妈执着呢？
I know because she's no good, but why?
为什么有争执呢？因为我知道，其实是因为她不好，但是真正的是为什么呢？
If you hold your opinion, no progress.
如果你执着你的知见，没有进展的。
If you keep don't know, then maybe the question appears, who is my mother?
那如果你保持不知呢，可能真正的问题会出现。我的妈妈是谁？
Then may if you pay attention, you'll see or understand something you didn't understand before.
那如果你专心的话，你可能就发现你之前没有注意到的事情。
Then correct love and compassion and wisdom can appear.
那正确的慈悲智慧都会显现。
That's how Kong'an practicing helps our life.
这就是Kong'an怎么帮助我们日常生活了。
Next question.
下一个问题。Good evening, masters. Happy smile, sad cry.We said that the reactions come from the true self, but scolded by someone, get angry. We say that that was not right and it's not from our true selves.
Four kinds of anger.
大师们，你们好。我们说开心、笑、伤心、哭，我们说这些都来自我们的自信，但是被骂、生气，我们却说这不对，也不是来自我们的自信。怎么回事呢？
Okay. There's four kinds of anger.
There are four kinds of anger. There are 四种嗔恨心。
First is attached anger.
有一种是执着的嗔恨。
Everybody has that.
每个人都有这种。
I can't get what I want, I get angry.
我得不到我所要的，就生气。
I lose something I want, I get angry.
我失去我所要的，我也生气。
I get something I don't want, I get angry.
我得到我所不要的，我也生气。
That's attached anger.
那是执着的。
That's the same as dog or cat.
那跟猫狗一样。
That's a kind of animal mind. Human beings also have that.
那一种畜生的心，人类也有。
Second kind of anger.
那第二种嗔恨心。
Reflected anger.
反映的嗔心。
You're driving along the road.
你在路上驾车。
You go into the next lane because you want to get off.
你转换，你换车道，因为你要停车了。
You don't realize you cut a little close to the guy behind you.
你不晓得，你不小心割入别人的车道。
He gets angry.
他生气。
Then he drives alongside of you and goes like this.
那他把车子架到你旁边，然后给你做一个手势。
Then soon your anger appears. You go like this back.
那你也生气，你就也是这样的。
You're not angry, but somebody gives you angry energy, then you automatically get it, give it back.
就是你并不生气，但是因为有人对你生气的时候，你反照那生气在嗔心。
You also get angry.
你也生气了，你也嗔起嗔心了。
Husbands and wives do that to each other all the time.
夫妻之间把这种事情常在夫妻之间发生。
Many people do that to each other.
很多人之间都发生这样的事情。
Dogs also do it to each other.
狗也这么做。
One dog's walking down the street, having a good time.
狗呢，在路上慢慢的走着走着。
Then another dog suddenly. Rah, 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 rah. Then this dog. Rah, rah, rah. Same, same.
那狗们也是这么的做，一样的，一样的。
That's also kind of animal mind. Human beings also have this mind.
那也是一种动物的心，人类也有动物的心。
That means a center not strong, mind not clear.
也就是说，心不正，心不清明。
But everybody has that.
但每个人都有这种情况出现。
Third kind of anger, we call it perceived anger.
第三种嗔心，我们叫做perceived, 观不是观照，sorry, give me some time. It takes a bit of time to process.
I'll explain it and then the word will come.
Okay, thank you.
This anger means inside getting angry, energy coming up, but outside not yet appear.
这第三种呢，就是说，里面呢开始感觉有那个嗔心的感觉，但是呢外面并没有显现。
You can perceive yourself the anger appearing inside of you, but it hasn't come into your speech or action yet. Nobody else knows.
你可以察觉到在你内心凸显的这种嗔心，但是因为还没有透过你的言行发出来，所以其他外人是不知道的。
That's a little high class.
那是比较高档的。
I think, I don't know, now everything's changing, but before I think women, and especially Asian women, trained in perceived anger. Whenever you perceive it, you must put it down.
那我觉得现在的亚洲妇女们都对这种内照的这种内观性的嗔心非常好的训练，他们看到，当你察觉到这趁心升起的时候呢，把它放下。
Probably everybody's experienced this.
那每个人都有这种察觉到的趁心。
Your anger starting to come up inside, you perceive it, but before it comes out in some way, you put it down.
大家也有这种情况，就是当你发现察觉到这趁心开始升起的时候呢，但是还没有转为化为言行的时候，其他人还没有察觉的时候呢，你把它压下去。
If you 100% put it down, which means complete let it go, no problem.
如果你百分之百，就是说你完全的把它放下呢，就是完全的放下之后呢，那没有问题。
But if you just push it down, then one day have a problem.
那如果你把这种嗔心一直压抑着呢，那有一天呢就会。
One day become sick.
有一天呢会生病。
Holding this anger inside, then.Maybe get cancer or heart attack or stomach problem.
那把这种嗔心一直压抑着呢，有一天可能会出现心脏病啦，或者可能癌症等等的。
Or one day explode.
或有一天呢爆发出来。
In America, that happens a lot.
在美国呢，这事情常发生的。
Somebody's very angry at work. Nobody knows.
在工作上有某些人在工作非常的不生气，但是没有人知道。
Every day they push it down, push it down, push it down.
每天呢，他们就把这个嗔心一直压抑着，压着，压抑着。
Then pressure getting stronger, stronger. Then one day go to work with a gun, then explode.
那个压力越来越大，越来越大。到了有一天呢，他就把回家抄家伙拿枪，然后上办公室。
So perceived anger is little hard class, little high class, but not finished yet.Problem can be problem.
这种察觉压抑的那种嗔心呢，是有点高档，但是还不完全。
Like I said, if you push it down, meaning you're still holding it, one day you will have a problem.
我就说呢，当你如果你一直把它压抑着，那没有把它消化呢，有一天就有问题了。
Fourth kind of anger we call big love anger.
那第四种嗔心呢，我们叫大爱嗔。
Perceived anger means inside angry, but outside not angry, not show.
压抑察觉，察觉压抑的那种嗔心呢，是内在，外面的人是不知道。
Big love anger means outside angry, but inside not angry.
那大爱的嗔心呢，就是外面表现的表现出把嗔心表现出来，但是内在是没有嗔心的。
That's like correct mother's mind.
那就是正确的母爱。
This anger not for me, inside not angry. Only some demonstration help this person.
那这嗔心呢，不是为我自己，只是一种表现，一种表演来帮助某一人。
Sung San Sinin, because he traveled so much, students sometimes would call him to talk something.
那因为宋山禅师常常到处去游说呢，那常常有学生打电话找他。
This happened at least a few. I saw this happened at least a few times.
那我亲眼见过这事情发生过几回。
He's someplace and the phone rings, then.Oh, hello. How are you?
那他在某个地点，然后有人电话响了，他就把电话拿起来说啊 ，Hello, 你好吗
？I've been with him in these situations.
当时我也在场。
Some student calling him.
那有些学生可能在打电话找他。
Oh, you have problem?
你有问题吗
？What kind of problem?
你有什么麻烦呢
？Oh, that thinking not so good.
啊，那种想法不太好。
No, not so good, not so good.
那不好，不好。
Ah, this thinking, put it down.
这种想法，哎，把它放下，把它放下。
No.
那不好。
I said, put it down.
我说把它放下。
Very red face, scream in the phone, slam the phone down.
他面红耳赤，很大声的喊，然后把电话砸下。
Then turn to me or somebody.Completely correct color.
那当他把面转向我的时候，或者任何其他在场人的时候呢，他的脸是完全正常。
Completely relaxed.
完全的放松。
He holding something, so I strong energy into.
因为他非常的执着，所以我用强而有力的能量转过去。
Inside never angry.
里面是。从来没有嗔心。
Only using anger help this person.
只是应用嗔心帮助这人，嗔相帮助这人。
So you must check your own mind. What kind of anger when anger appears?
所以你要观察你的心，当你的嗔心嗔相起的时候是什么样的心
？Some people very angry. You beat the children and say, "This is for you," but inside also angry.
有些人呢，非常的非常生气的打孩子，只是为了你好，但是他内心也是生气的。
So, you must check your own angry mind.
那你要审查你们自己的内在人的嗔心。
Also, you must perceive when yelling will help, when yelling or shouting won't help.
那你也得观察，什么时候大声呐喊会有帮助，什么时候大声呐喊是没有帮助的。
If it won't help, but you yell, that's for you.
如果帮助不了事情，但是你在大声呐喊的呢，那是你为自己的。
Or if you perceive suddenly it won't help, you can immediately let it go because not about me, not my feeling.
或者呢，你当你大声呐喊的时候，你发现它于事无补，你能够马上放下呢，那就不是为你自己的了。
Okay, that question somebody asked. Happy, somebody happy, I happy. Somebody sad, I sad. Somebody angry, you must perceive what will help. Not just angry. That's my anger. Not just reflect angry. You must perceive. Then, if shout can help, shout. If it doesn't help, you better drop it quickly. Or watch out.
好吗？那就刚才别人所问的，那个有个人所问的问题，就是开心你反照开心，沮丧你反映的是沮丧。 那如果是生气嗔恨的时候呢，你就得先得关照到底是帮还是怎么帮，喊还是不喊呢，你自己看着办。
Even sad, sad, reflect sad, that's also not enough.
那其实呢，就算是伤心反照伤心，那是不足够的。
Maybe your baby is crying.
可能你的宝宝在哭。
A little baby, lay down, cry, cry, cry.
小 baby, 小宝宝躺在那哭啊。
Oh, I'm Zen student, I only reflect, so I also lay down, cry, cry, cry.
那我就说我只是反照，然后我也躺在他旁边，然后在也不会在那边哭啊。
So we call that just like this.
那我就把它叫做是只是这样。
Just like this means perfect connect.
只是这样呢，就表示完全的沟通。
So maybe your friend's mother dies, you go to visit, they're crying, then you also feel very sad.
那可能你朋友的母亲过世，那你去吊丧的时候，你也是跟着他，你看到你朋友哭呢，你也是感觉内心非常的伤心。
So you connect, same feeling.
所以因为大家有同感同受 感受，所以你也能够沟通。
One more step necessary.
但是你还需要多踏出一步。
Then maybe you say, oh, let's chant, 阿弥陀佛阿弥陀佛 for your mother.
那你可以可能说你说哎，我们一起来为你母亲念诵阿弥陀佛。
Your baby crying, sad. Then you also sad.
那你看到小宝宝在哭伤心，你也感到伤心。
One more step, how help the baby.
那多一步怎么帮助这小宝宝？
So two kinds of reflect.
所以有两种的反照。
One is the same feeling, same action, correct?
那
reflect.
那有一种是同样的感受，同样的行动的反照。
One is the same feeling, same, but how help?
另外一种呢是同样的感受的反照，行为的反照，但是再多一样就是怎么的帮助。
So two different kinds of reflect.
所以有两种的反照。
We also learn that during Kong'an practice.
我们在公案的时候也学过这个。
You're hungry, you eat.
你饿了，你吃。
Somebody's hungry, then you also hungry.
别人饿，你也饿吗？
But you just ate lunch, so.
可是你刚吃过呀。
So different style reflect. Somebody's hungry, give them food.
所以有 不一样风格的反应，就是反照，就是别人饿了，你给他吃的。
Okay, next question.
好吗？下一个问题。Question: Most meditation teach us to focus energy on the sixth chakra to calm the mind, or the seventh chakra to gain more energy to the brain. Here, it teaches us to focus energy on the diaphragm. Please explain.Translation. 那一般的静坐法门呢，就都教我们说把能量专注在第六气轮来把心安抚，或者第七气轮呢来增加能量，就是疏导能量去大脑。那这里呢叫我们把能量都专注在横膈膜，请解释。
Is there a question in there or just that statement?
It's a request for explanation.
Oh, okay. If you attach to your chakra, doesn't matter, 6, 7, 1, 2, then when you die, what will you do? Your chakra all gone. That body's just a garbage, nothing. Burn it, it's just dust. So if you attach to chakra, what will you do when you die?
那其实都一样，无论第六、第七、第八、第一、第二、第三。当你执着你这些气轮的时候呢，当你死亡的时候，它是你的身体，这些气轮都消失了，那时候你怎么办？当你执着你的气轮的时候，你怎么办？
In our style, the person wrote in there, yeah, we focus here.
那我们这个风格呢，我们的形式呢，就是当我们把专注力专注在这里。
That's only technique.
这只是一种技巧。
We say your body's energy center here.
我们说你身体的能量中心是在这里。
So when we grow inside our mother, that is the body's energy center.
当我们在我们的胚胎的时候，在我们母胎的里面的时候呢，这是我们的能量中心是正确的。
When you're in your mother, all the energy coming and going here.
当你在你的母胎的时候呢，你所有的能量都是来自进出都来自这里啊。
But when we're born Everybody's energy center moves here.
可是当我们出世的时候呢，我们大每一个人的那个能量中心都移到这里来了，嘴巴呢。
So when a baby can grab something, soon into the mouth.
那当小婴儿呢能够抓某件事情，他能够抓的时候呢，物件的时候呢，他们都把它往嘴边里面、
Watch.
嘴巴里面送。
Keys, handphone, your dirty finger, doesn't matter. Kid can grab it into the mouth.
手表、手机、你的手指，不论什么，一抓就放往嘴里放。
Somebody's, some people's energy center stays here their whole life, talking, eating, drinking.
有些人的能量中心呢，一生都保持在这里，一直讲话，一直说话，一直喝吃的。
But most people, 1 or 2 years old, energy center moving here.Opposite thinking.
那大概到了一二岁的时候呢，能量中心就往这里移了，移到大脑里面，就是相对性的思考思维。
Me, you.
你我。
Happy, sad.
开心不开心。
Success, failure.
成功失败。
Good, bad.
好坏。
Life, death.
生死。
But those things are only thinking ideas. They don't exist.In original nature as opposites.
那些呢都是你的想法，他们在事实里面是没有存在的，这是你的所思想所制造出来的。
So our style is return your energy here.
那我们的方式呢，就是方法呢，就是把你的能量回到这一点。
You know, if you're very emotional or lots of thinking, you eat food, no energy here, then cannot digest.
那就如你吃很多东西，还有很多情绪的时候呢，你的能量都在这里，不能够消化。
Even if you eat good food, you cannot digest it, makes you sick.
就算你吃好吃的食物呢，但是你不能够消化的话，你也会生病。
But if your energy is down and your center is strong, even if you eat bad food,You can digest it. It just becomes fresh energy.
但是呢，如果你的能量中心强，你吃任何东西能够消化，就算吃生吃呢，你也会能够消化，也能转化成纯正的力量。
In the same way, if you have experience and your energy is up here, then you always will think about your experience in opposites, not digest it.
同样的，当你有某一些经验的时候呢，如果你把能量都储存在这里，你就把那个能量，把你的经验转化为二元的思维。
If you bring your energy down, you can digest any thinking, any opinion, any emotion, any situation.
但是如果你能够让你的中心往下沉到丹田呢，那你就能够消化一切的处境、一切的条件、一切的问题、一切的情绪、一切的思维。
Then it just becomes fresh, clear energy. We call it dharma energy, not karma energy.
那我们就把这转化，把它转化成一种纯能力或纯能量，我们叫它做这种叫做法力。
Then you can use it with wisdom.
那你可以用智慧来运用这种法力。
Even bad experience, bad emotion, if you digest it, it just is dharma energy. Not good, not bad.
那就算是不好的经验、不好的情绪，你也能够消化。它只是一种能量，没有好也没有坏。
So I started to say before, everybody has opinion, but if you digest opinion, you can attain truth.
每一个人的，我刚才说过了，每个人都有这种观念，都有不同的观念。但是如果你能够把你的观念消化掉呢，观念就变成了真理。
Truth just means.See clearly, hear clearly, smell clearly. That's all.
真理呢，就只是看清楚、听清楚、闻清楚，就这样。
Not good or bad.
没有好，没有坏。
Sky is blue. Is that good or bad?
天是蓝色的，是好是坏呢
？Cloud is white. Is that good or bad?
云是白，好是坏呢
？Dog goes woof woof. Is that good or bad?
狗汪汪叫，那是好还是坏呢
？Our thinking makes it good or bad.
是我们的思维把它转为是好和坏。
Finally, life and death, is that good or bad?
那最终生死是好还是坏呢
？That's just made by thinking.
那只是你的思维所制造出来的。
Maybe we should cry when we're born and be very happy when we die. Why not?
有没有想过，可能我应该在我们出世的时候哭，然后在我们死的时候开心的笑？
It's just our opinion.
为什么不？那只是我们的一种想法，理念罢了。
So if we our centers are strong and clear, opinion digest, we attain truth. Emotion digest, we attain correct love.
所以呢，当我们的中心非常强的时候呢，观念、想法、理念，我们消化了，变成了真理；情绪，我们消化了，变成了大爱。
Love is not a feeling.
大爱不是一种感觉。
Nowadays, everybody thinks love is a feeling. I love you. I love you.
慈爱不是一种情绪，大家现在大家都觉得哦，我爱你，我爱你是一种情绪。
Get married.
啊，就结婚。
One year, yeah, it's not so bad.
一年还可以忍受。
Second year, little problems.
第二年问题开始出现了。
Third year, fighting, separate.
第三年就打架，然后分开。
That's not love. That's like. I like you. Then soon, opposite appears. I don't like you.
那不是爱，那只是喜欢。第一年我喜欢你，第二年我不喜欢你。
If your ears are clear, somebody walk up to you when you're young. I love you. Then soon you understand. No, thank you.
但是如果你年轻的时候你的耳朵清明的话，你小的时候当有人走过来跟你说我爱你，你会说不谢谢。
If you don't understand, maybe the words trap you, then 20 years later, mistake.
如果你不明白看不听不清楚的话，那你让你的你让那声音把你勾去了，那可能20年后你会觉得哎大错。
Also, understanding. That's not mine. Somebody's idea into my head.
其实呢，所谓的了解、理解呢、明白呢，都是不是我的，是别人的想法和理念。
But if you digest your understanding, it becomes wisdom.
但是当你把你的所理解的消化了，那你就把它转变成你的智慧。
That's our style.
这就是我们的
风格。Other training systems have other style.Maybe, what, six chakra, seven chakra. But when we die, this center disappear, this chakras all disappear. Then what will you do?
那可能其他修行的风格是不一样，说可能第六七轮，第七轮，或者我们修行这里。可是当你的死的时候，你死亡的时候，你的身体消失，那你怎么办？
So in Buddhism, in Zen, we understand, talking about Dantian, that's justTechnique, but our true center is the whole universe.
可是呢，在我们禅宗里面，虽然我们说把能量安置在你的丹田，但这只是一个技巧。你真正的中心是整片宇宙。
The true center is no center at all, so no problem. Die, no problem, still clear.
真正的中心是没有中心，所以当你死亡的时候没有问题。
So don't attach the technique.
因为一切清明，所以不用执着那些技巧。
If you become your practice is clear, even sit on the toilet and your energy center down here, no problem, get enlightenment.
如果你的修行清明的话，就算你蹲在马桶上，你的能量中心跑到下面那边，但是你也可能会开悟，没有问题。
So only go straight, don't know, don't attach to.Dantian, don't attach to 127 something.
所以不要
Only don't know.
所以只往不知，不要执着什么丹田啊，第一七轮、第五七轮什么的，只是只往不知。
Then slowly, slowly become clear. Then you can use anything, help others.
那就慢慢的、慢慢的清明，那你就可以运用一切的帮助众生。
So now 9 o'clock, we finish.
现在呢，9点整。
So,
我们结束了。
Any other questions you bring tomorrow to the workshop? Then, if that's those are second questions, first from everybody tomorrow, but we also can try them.
那剩下的这5个问题呢？我们今晚就不回答，我们留到明天回答。那这5个问题呢，就留到明天的第二批，因为第一批问题呢，我们留给在场的观众。那这些问题我们留到第二批，
so,
好吗？
Shimhasinim, you in charge of the questions. Okay? So, thank you very much. So, tonight, sleep time only sleep. Try it, okay?
那好了，今晚睡觉的时候只是睡觉，好吗？
Good night.
晚安。
Thank you.
谢谢。
谢谢。